Hello, my name's Neil Postlethwaite, and I would like to show you how easy it is to attach electronics to textiles projects using positronics conductive thread. Positronics conductive thread acts and behaves like conventional thread. The only difference is it has small iron filaments within the thread, which makes it act and behave like wires within an electronic circuit. Attaching electronics to textiles projects has never been easier with the use of positronics conductive thread kit. The average kit comes with a coin cell holder, two LEDs, which could be flashing green, flashing red, or multicolour changing LEDs, a small strip of Velcro for attaching the battery cell holder to the textiles project, 2 meters of positronics conductive thread, and a cell battery, double it. The standard equipment needed to attach electronics to textiles projects is a sewing needle and a set of pliers. Now I will demonstrate how easy it is to attach electronics into textiles projects. First of all, attach conductive thread to the positive side of the cell holder. Using another strip of positronics conductive thread, attach the conductive thread to the negative side of the cell holder. To attach a thread, simply loop through the hole, and tie a knot. Cut off the excess thread. Position battery holder on the desired position. Using the Velcro. For this demonstration, I'll just do a simple circuit, no switches involved. I will just light 2 LEDs under the fabric. What we're basically going to do is, using the simplest circuit gun, from the positive side, we're going to run the conductive thread, sewn it along to the positive side of the LED. Positive side of the LED is always shown by the longest leg. From the negative side, we're going to go to the negative leg, which is the short leg. Okay, so we're going to run the stitching along here, attach to the positive leg, run the stitching along here, and attach to the negative leg. Now you're thinking, how are we supposed to attach electronics to the legs when the legs are straight? This is easily rectified by using a set of pliers to curl the legs with the LED so the stitching can be sewn on or tied on. For the purpose of the demonstration, I will only put a couple of running stitches in between. do we touch LED to the textiles, put a couple of loops around the leg of the LED, and tie off. Repeat the process for the positive side of the LED. Putting running stitches to where the touch LED the same way as the negative. Loop the thread and tie off. For it to work properly. Now, when the battery is inserted, electronics, you start to flash. This circuit is exactly the same as that circuit, apart from the positive line has been cut and attached to either side of the zip. The LEDs shown are on the surface area of the material. To hide the stitching, the LEDs are pushed through the material to show the LED legs on the opposite side. This hides the conductive thread and the workings of the textiles project. If you notice, when the zips open, the LEDs are off. This is because the zip is not attached to make the circuit. And for a circuit to work, there must be a constant flow. When the zip is shut, the LEDs come on. The light stitches project, this is Positronic's pencil case, which works as shown earlier. Using the conductive thread to attach LEDs to textiles projects, and the zip to act as a switch. Conductive velcro can also be used as a switch. Works in exactly the same way as the previous example, apart from the positive track is broken using conductive velcro. So when the velcro is placed together, the circuit is made. The project shown here uses press studs, metal press studs, so when these are connected, the circuit is made. The LED shown is a multicoloured changing LED, which cycles through various colours.